said, on a serious note, Bambi, we don't want to be single, but them lad niggas are out there to get us, right? Sisters, say amen. Why did you write about love niggas? I wish you had a chapter about them. Because, Tufa,
whoever gave us that term, we are grateful.
Rema.
Choose not to say. But I didn't write about them, but they are a reality as a part of the journey. But the reason why I wanted to challenge the norms is that people who are afraid to be single can choose to rather be single than be with a love nigga. Yeah, so that at least be with yourself than be with a love nigga. That is why.
So you rather be single than have an imposter seated in your house, amen? Sisters. Secondly, Julie, I just want to know, we've been talking, in the book you write about love languages. And you know, some people's love languages is receiving gifts and, you know, giving around. Is it so bad if my love language is receiving money? For me, that's all I know. These other things, man, you touch, what? That's all rubbish. For me, mine, is it bad?
Well, I think, as you say in the book, I have mentioned that we have to actually understand ourselves, have self-awareness, and tell your gift is. You want to receive money, then your partner should know. Instead of buying you a blender, they should give you that cash. And you go with your cash, you decide what you want to buy with it. But then also on your part, even though you want to receive money as a, you know, as an expression of love, you don't impose it on your partner and say, okay, even me, I'm going to give you cash. Maybe your partner wants, you know, time or touch. Yeah. So you have to understand one another.
Okay. Why is it that when we grow, everybody is like, where is he? But you're the same people. All my life, it's an abomination to bring trousers or a skirt home. Now I have finished university, I'm making my money. Everybody's like, is there a problem? I need to talk. Banana, what is happening with Ruby? Nothing! You're not interested when I was in P7. So now, why do you want him when I'm... So, who do we blame?
I think honestly this is why I wrote the book, so that we can be able to actually see what parts of our society or cultural practices do we need to edit. You understand? So one of the things that I'm grateful for is that my parents were my friends. And as such, this is something that was not an abomination. Of course, I'm sure they had some, you know, mango going on, but they tried to, you know, they tried to say, okay,
Madeline, is that true? The mango was there.
Yes. Who is this person? Who is that? Where did they come from? But instead of chasing them, they now made the effort to know who this person is. So what's their family like? Where do they go to school? What are you spending your time doing? So instead of chasing, could you try to explore what is the character of the person that your child is bringing home? It could truly just be a friend, but that friend could then introduce that person to the wrong love nigga. Yeah, so.
Love niggas, eh?
Samba Kadari, you must Samba Kadari. Some sort of routine exercise. But I think it's important that you set criteria for the partners you want to get involved with if you're going to get married to them. You should, in your mind, have about 10 grounds for a husband or for a wife. Somebody shakes his head. He thinks that 4 on 10, you know, 10 on 10, I don't know how many things they should be. But if you find one with 4 out of 10, that's marriage material. Yeah, sure, because you're going to find a 5th. along the way. And you're going to help him or her cultivate the sixth. And 60% was always a good grade in academic. I don't know about now. You'll become senile if you don't read. And the social media things won't save you. A book like Juliana's could save you. So it's my own and pleasure to declare the book Becoming Mrs. James launched.
Information is going to conquer the world, and there is plenty of information in what's written in the different books that one can get their hands on. So if you don't have information, you are not likely to succeed. So they've got to learn that to succeed, which everyone yearns, they've got to find information, and you get that in the books.
Well, the book is about a story about possibilities for choosing happiness along the journey from singlehood and into marriage, and really trying to see how we can challenge the pressure that comes along with social and cultural norms to, you know, help us to make good choices for ourselves along the way. Yeah, this is generally what the book is about.
Marriage brings stability to a young person. Of course, when you are not married, you are free. You can do all of whatever you want to do. But when you are married, you get stability and you think about the future. Every young person must think about the future, because the future will come to them. So you need to plan, you need to get into marriage, stabilize, to plan for the future together with someone. I think it's more fruitful with a partner.
If we could be as active in preparing for our marriages as we are, let's say for work. I mean, if I have a presentation at work, I would take like a whole week putting in that effort. Why can't I do the same thing if I'm in a relationship, you see? So I bless the Lord for what you did. And I believe, like I told you, we've talked, this book is a new thing.